Hi, my name is Chintan, and I have a question for you. Have you ever experienced the feeling of frustration when you were stuck in traffic and then got late to work or some other place where you were supposed to be? Well, if the answer is yes, then it's not surprising. As a recent traffic report suggested that you might be spending roughly 50 hours in a year just being stuck in traffic. Now imagine spending this valuable time with your loved ones, learning a new skill, or simply enjoying 10 minutes of extra nap each morning. So, as a transport engineer, I often get this question that don't we have desired tools and resources to address the congestion problem? My answer to this question is, yes, we do. However, right tools do not guarantee the right solution. It's how we utilize them that matters. The same is with our traffic management systems. Currently, the traffic management systems are reactive. That means we utilize our tools and resources to see if the congestion exists on our roads. Then, if we observe the congestion, we think of the ways in which it can be solved. Therefore, even with the most advanced technology in the future, we are still likely to face the same congestion as what we are observing today. Addressing this problem, my research focuses on predicting when and where can the congestion occur in the future. So how do I do this? It's a three-step process. First, I observe the vehicles at different intersections on the road. I then develop algorithms to convert these observations into meaningful individual trips. Don't worry, this information is anonymous to me, but it helps me understand when and where do people travel. Not only that, it also helps me understand which paths do people choose and consider under a given traffic condition. I aggregate this information for several individuals over a long period of time to make travel predictions. No, I don't use tarot cards to do so, but instead, I develop my own mathematical model that can help me understand the human behavior. This might be something like predicting whether an individual will choose a path with minimum distance, minimum time, or the one that is most familiar to them. This research is therefore very useful to traffic managers, as they can predict the arrival of the vehicles at different intersections. They can then use this information to manage traffic signals or adjust road speeds so that the overall congestion on the network is minimized. By doing so, this research helps you in saving time, reducing cost on fuel, enhancing your road safety, but most importantly, reducing the frustration while traveling. Thank you.